How's it going, everybody? Blover King here. Gonna be doing some more NASCAR The Game 2011. Next up on our plate is gonna be Bristol. I'm kinda nervous for this racetrack. Cause a couple things. Number one, it's a short track, an NTG, anything could happen. Plus, we wanna make sure not to be getting any like illegal pit road entries, cause even if you spin out on one of the corners and you hit one of the cones, guess what? You're gonna get black flagged. So we're gonna hope that doesn't happen. I think I'm going to keep all these things the same. Yeah, they all look good. Do I qualify? I guess I'm qualifying. So we're going to give that a shot for the first time. We're going to see how well I qualify. It's been a very long time since I've raced at this track. And this actually kind of shows how many times I've raced. Or only twice. I've won both times, though. So not bad. So maybe I'm a little bit better here than I give myself credit for, but that was obviously probably like 4 years ago that I did those two races, so things definitely have changed since then. Hopefully I start like in the top 30 at least. And oh, it's actually me controlling it. I was just holding the gas, waiting for it to let me go, but I guess I control myself out of pit road. See how we do it here in our first qualifying session. I might only qualify for like Bristol and Martinsville. Oh my god. If that's an indication of things to come, I'm not going to be in for a good time here. Let's try not to hit that wall again. Hit the apron. Scrape the wall. 30th. Hey, so like I said, top 30 is what I got to push for. Much better lap going this time, though. Let's see where that puts me. 11th. Not bad. Not bad at all. There's my times there. Definitely did a lot better on the second lap. I mean, that means we could potentially have a shot at winning this race, maybe, since we're starting up near the front. Hopefully I didn't just jinx myself there. Because like I said, if I screw up and I spin, like if you look down in the apron there, and I hit the pit road, I mean, it's over. I'll be a couple laps down, more than likely. And once that happens, I mean, in this game, unless I purposely cause cautions, which I really don't want to do, I probably won't be getting those laps back. So let's be fairly patient here. Just bide my time. I mean, I've already got good track position, which is more than I can say for the other three races I've done so far in my career, which means immediately put it three wide in the first lap. Go around Trevor Bayne here. It's rare to see Tony Stewart up front, at least in current NASCAR. Though today he did just have his first race back after being injured in that Baja thing, or in some like sand dune. Car, like sand rail, I think is what it is. He finished like 20th, I want to say, so mid-pack, but could be a lot worse for him. Who knows, maybe he'll pull a Kyle Busch and like miss almost all the races, and then he'll win one race or two, maybe get in the top 30 in points, and then win the championship in his final year. I wouldn't be very happy if that happened, because I wasn't very happy that it even happened to Kyle Busch, even though it's not really Kyle Busch's fault. I mean, he just kind of did his own thing and followed NASCAR's rules, but still don't like that drivers can miss like 10 races or something and still be champion. It just feels weird. Doesn't feel like they've really earned it for going through the whole season. But I guess that's what this new chase thing is about. Just win and you're in. That's all it takes, is win one race and all of a sudden, boom, you got a shot. No longer about points racing, which should be good for my driver, because Casey Kane is probably the least consistent driver I think I've ever seen in my life. If we have a few good weeks and all of a sudden follow him up with like three finishes of like 30th or worse. I gotta actually pay attention here, because I keep hitting the wall coming off turn 4. Whoa. Accidentally hit him in the back bumper and almost spun myself out. Bristol, though. I gotta get into him a little bit. Kinda like Carl Edwards. Doing a little bump and run on Kyle in the race today. It's pretty nice. I mean, it's not like I hate Kyle, even though he's wrecked Casey a lot, but I don't know. I think just because all the announcers suck up to him, it gets on my nerves sometimes. Kind of the same reason why, like, Dale Earnhardt is not necessarily my favorite driver either, is that I think he's a fine driver. I actually like him as a person, but just the way they emphasize him all the time, just, it's like, okay, let's talk about other people now. It looks like there's the back of the field, so let's see who maneuvers traffic better. It does feel nice, though, being actually, like, up near the front. Even though I kind of feel cheap right now for qualifying, but whatever. It is what it is. Okay. Juan Pablo. Why? Oh, there we go. Even though I'm pretty sure I keep my position. I was not paying attention to... Boyer must be pitting. I'm going to start on the outside. I was not paying attention to what fuel was like, so maybe I should have pitted there and just got my my fuel. Well, I can actually... So it looks like we can make it all the way. It's just whether or not our tires will hold up is going to be the biggest thing. So I'm pretty sure you can blow a tire in this game. Just from wear, too. See, I can never get off of turn 4 right. Turn 2, I'm fine. Right there, beautiful. Here, you just gotta, like, really cut it down, but it's still right up on you. And I'm leading green flag laps, yay. Looks like this could be... Now, I don't want to jinx myself here. This could be the first win of the season, maybe. Which would make sense, because Casey Kane's pretty good at Bristol. Got a win there. He should have won the race I actually went to. I went to the fall, or the night race in 2012. He had a really good car. He was leading until he got oil and hit the wall. Still made a good comeback. He finished like ninth or something, but I was very angsty that day. Because I was like, man, might I actually see my driver win in Cup once? Because I did see him win at Homestead in 2004, I think, in the trucks. But that's the only time I've ever seen my favorite driver win. Of course, the year I lived in Charlotte, which was 2014, I did go to the races there. But he didn't win any of the races that year there, which kind of sucked. Because that's like his best track, hands down. And of course, the next year he wins that awesome. He had that awesome win at Charlotte in the trucks, where he just barely beat Eric Jones. I would have flipped out if I was actually at that race, or possibly have like died of a heart attack, just because I get super stressed out when he actually has a chance to win. Man, I am just pulling away from these guys. I'm ahead. There we go. Somebody told me to change the ticker to actually, like, see where, like, every driver is, I guess. I thought I did that earlier, but maybe I didn't. I got 3 seconds, it looks like, at least on most of the field. Man, I hate Bristol in this game. Well, I can't say I hate the whole track, just turn 4. Alright, let's be patient. I got a big lead. Jeez, OP, I was off the gas there and still pushed up the track. Super patient now. Sorry, dude. I think that's... Ooh, whoa, Clint Bowyer. Why is he so far back? He died? Like, what? Wasn't he... Oh, wait, no, he pitted. That's right. I was like, wasn't he, like, in first at some point? But that's what he gets for pitting. Which, honestly, maybe I should have pitted there. No, Juan Pablo didn't pit. So we'll just, I guess, drive until my tires blow out. Because they look pretty red up there, actually. Freaking Montoya body slams me. Thanks, dude. Fight back. Crossover. Sorry. there. Not really sorry, actually. I don't feel like there's been much fall off, honestly, in these tires. As I just get almost my fastest lap of the race, yeah. Ooh, that was a bad decision. Very bad decision. Drove it in that corner way too hard. Ugh, God. Who's behind me now? Is that Biffle? No, that's still on Pablo. Just the lighting's weird. Still got in the wall, even though it was past the safer barrier. Let's just get this race over with. 19 more laps. I think they just said that the crew's on the wall, fresh tires, so let's hope that doesn't mean I blow a tire. Let's hope that if I do, that my pit stall's on the front straightaway, which I think the minimap kind of shows that it should be.
Yeah, I saw that.
Since the backstretch pit road is all like a dotted line. Oh yeah, I'm starting to feel the wear on the tires now. I guess this is going to be an experiment. Can you actually blow a tire? Which, like I said, I'm pretty sure you can. Let's hope my tires will last another 15 or so laps. I swear that the AI does not have, like, near the falloff that I do. So I'm not pulling away from Montoya anymore. If anything, he's actually catching me now. My car is pushing just like an absolute dump truck in turns 1 and 2. Okay, so now we're at the back of the pack again. Stenhouse, gonna go. That was a really bad decision. Crap, now what do I do? Gosh, I don't know. I guess I'll risk it and stay out. I mean, I could. I'm probably gonna greatly. Regret not pitting, but whatever. Let's see if Montoya stays out. Yep, he's going for it like I am. 12 laps, here we go. Got around him. Tires are starting to get really red. Being really quiet now because I'm just waiting for my tire to blow. Yikes. Yeah, I'm definitely not pulling away from him too. Like if I smash into the wall once coming off turn 4, they could easily pass me. Spin out. Man, my car's really loose now, too. Gosh, Montoya's right there. No, 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 no. Alright, we're gonna have to battle, boys. We have to battle it out. Jeez, Tony, no! Gosh, I think I'm gonna pit. I mean, I know that's probably the stupidest decision ever, but you know what? No. Yes, no, yes, no. Nope, we're not gonna do it. We're just gonna go for it, guys. We've already made our bid, let's lie in it. We're gonna be restarting. Second, third, second, okay. Whoa, we just like stopped in the middle of the straightaway. Try not to push them into the wall. Though they almost made me wreck. And I'm gonna wreck again. Maybe not. Man, I should have pitted like 20 laps ago. Tony Stewart, what are you doing? Jeez, oh Pete. Man, this is definitely a fail. I don't need to pit for fuel, but I definitely should have pit for tires. I don't know why. Oh, it's because he stops. I was like, why is he the cause of the caution? Still not gonna pit though. YOLO. Green, white, checkered actually. Or technically not, since it's like 3 laps ago. Jeez, oh Pete, people. Okay, I'm gonna have to pit, because, like, my tires, I can't even do anything on them. I literally cannot do anything on them. Oh, that's the big one. That's the big one, boys. Yeah, you know how I said, like, in that caution, like, at lap 20, that I probably should have pitted? Yeah, I definitely should have. Ooh. David Gillen just destroyed my car. I think he's in the 38 at least. Well, let's see if anybody else pits with us. Maybe. Under caution, we have to go under the whole pit road, I guess. Anybody coming with? Of course not. I'm the only sad sack, and this is going to take forever. Let's sit here and wait. All 4 tires. Well, I thought this might be the place where I got my first win. Especially since I started 11th. But, it just didn't fall that way, I guess. I mean, unless an absolute miracle happens, this isn't going to go very well. If I didn't have all those cautions where I spun out, I would have been fine. But I think spinning out all those times really wreaked havoc on my tires. All lonely, going down pit road. Super slow, and then the super slow motion pit stop. God, the damage is so bad in this game. I remember them hyping it up like, oh, it's gonna look so good. And it's like, that's just not how damage works, you technics. It's just not how it works. And they were so proud of these, like, pit stop things. Cool, so I'm not quite in last. But I'm also not quite in first. So, and if you ain't first, you're last. Let's hope these scrubs, though, have super old tires and I can just blow through them. But that's probably not the case. Try to pass as many cars as possible. I'm really not trying to crash, I swear. It's just so difficult. I'm definitely trying to make my way through, and I was trying not to spin out there myself. So, sorry, Mark Martin. Don't worry, I'll take your ride next year. I'm pretty sure we might be at our limit of green-white checkers. I don't think they'll allow another one. So let's not spin out. Fourth, 23rd, 20th. Gosh, that was close. That was so close to me spinning out. AJ Allmendinger, why? So it looks like for like the third week in a row, I'm going to finish between 15th and 20th. Oh boy. At least I made it up that far. It could have been a whole lot worse, especially if I spun out there. Because, like I said, I don't think the caution would have came out when I would have finished dead last. What's next week? What was it back then? Was it Martinsville? I really hope it's not Martinsville. I don't need another short track to make me all stressed out. I led 31 laps. I had the fastest lap, but like I said, I should have been smart like Clint Bowyer and pitted back then. Of course, he didn't make it up there either. So Juan Pablo Montoya gets his first oval track win, at least unofficially, since it's a video game. Jimmy Johnson back up there. Tony Stewart. Michael Waltrip, that scumbag, finishing sixth. Go down, go down. There's me. My rival. Did be my rival, so that's good. Going down, going down, going down. There's Clint Bowyer. Yeah, it didn't work out well for him either. And Josh Wise. Poor Josh Wise. Not see the points. Am I still... And I am. I actually gained a position, so that's good. Who's leading the points now? Kyle Busch. Jeff Gordon in the top five. Three Hendrick cars in a row. Could almost say four, but Casey wasn't in Hendrick at this time. Rudiman in the chase. Kevin Harvick. Man, who fell way out? Somebody must have won. Pablo Montoya gaining 12 positions. Clint Bowyer. Oh, my teammate Brian Vickers. I didn't even see where he finished. That sucks for him. Just keep going down. It's definitely shaked up the points. And Tabodine gains a position. He's no longer last. Yay. Well, that kind of sucks. I was hoping to do better. Especially, like I said, starting 11th, but... You know, what can you do? It's Bristol. Things happen. I wrecked a lot. I mean, I don't even know how many cautions there were, like 8. But on to next week, which we'll see here in a second what it is. Like I said, I'm hoping it's not Martinsville, but I think it is. Trying to think back to the schedule. No, it's Auto Club. Martinsville's next week. So Auto Club, I think I can handle a little bit better. I won't qualify for this next one, though, because like I said, I think I'm only going to do that for like Bristol and Martinsville, probably. All the other tracks I should be fine at. So I guess tune in next time to where we tackle Auto Club Speedway.